Paletta Park. Just right on Lakeshore in Burlington. So we're going to find out what we have behind those trees.
I'm setting up to paint this composition with the just a bit of the water, but mostly I'm focusing on the rocks and the bridge and the trees in the background. Things are not just like horizontal and vertical, but there's like angular elements to it. The way the shadow falls, the way the angle of the bridge goes, the rocks. Just add some visual excitement. So I'm going to work with this as my composition.
Okay, today I'm going to do a mid-tone painting. The subject is the picture behind me is that, you know, broken tree trunk. You know, it's a gray day, so I'm going to use the mid-tone, probably going into the darker value. And I'm using a 16 by 20 inches canvas. I'm going to get started.
It did record you sketching it in, didn't it?
No, it didn't. I know.
Thank you. Do you have any sage advice to give your audience?
Bring a lot of paper towel, because our nose is going to run continuously.
That's good.
That's it. That's the best. I think it's beautiful. Look at this. I like patterns, the vertical and the and horizontal. This part, I believe that is your focal point, and the way it kind of like slide down here and the shadow here is, you know, it make the painting kind of like very feedy through. And the minimalistic of color you apply. Make the painting is so simple, honest, and I really like it.
Thank you, Peter.
I think it's fantastic, Peter. As I said before, my first reaction was I feel like there's something that reminds me of Van Gogh, and which means, I guess I'm saying it's like a masterpiece because it reminds me of a master's work. But no, I think it's, I mean, partially, you mentioned it before, part of it is that you're using color to interpret a lot of gray tones. And so you definitely have your cools and your warms. And I don't know, I think it's just proved the color, it really sings in that respect. Like, you know, you have this band here of warmth, and then it's like contrasted by these blue and greens that are going like that. And then, you know, obviously you're suggesting these trees, and you allow things to blur into the background so that it creates definite focal points here and there. So, and then I just like how you almost silhouetted this trunk here, which gives it that extra emphasis, you know, as a focal point. So, yeah, I really like it. It's fantastic work, Peter.
Thank you.